First of two bronze medals at 65, and some early offense right out of the gate by Kyrgyzstan, and a quick four.
Feet to back. He set that up by changing his level, reached up, changed his level again, blast through a double, and was able to expose Biemkowski's back, but they only gave two on it. They didn't see him exposed, so only our main official called the four. The judge and the chairman both said it was 2 points.
Yeah, and I was surprised to see the initial four. I didn't think it. I was ready to say two, and then I was like, four, okay. I missed it, but a good start nonetheless for Osmanov. You love to see that offense right off the whistle, and that's what he was able to dial up. Took seventh at this year's Asian Championships when you look at the wrestler from Kyrgyzstan. Inadvertent poke to the eye, and the referee will stop it. Well, you take a look at these guys inside the tunnels, and we're not telling anybody who follows the sport something new. They're just beat up. I mean, their faces are gouged, bruised, cut, bloodied.
I sit at the head table and do the PA for the earlier rounds, and person sitting next to me is UWW's social media person, and they were doing some headshots, and the faces of champions when they come off the mat, and stitches and marks and scuffs, and just a look of toughness, men and women.
Plenty of battle scars for these elite athletes competing, representing their countries. Halfway through period one, the quick barrage right out of the gate by Osmanov, the difference, and we will get the passivity. Verbal warning given to the Polish wrestler. He's a staple back in Poland, won the national championship in that country in 2020. He's took part in 9 European championships throughout his tenure. Represented Poland in Nur-Sultan a couple of years ago at the World Championships. Things did not go his way that year. He has changed it and really kept the momentum that he built from Warsaw this summer and carried it right into Oslo.
Red action! And our official asking for red action. He already has one warning for passivity. I'll give him about 5-10 more seconds. If you don't see him make an attack, they're going to call him for his second passivity. You see the mat judge tapping the red paddle on his table. But now with 30 seconds to go in the period, they're not going to call it. But a 2-point takedown for Osmanov.
Trying to go into a wrench right away. Chain wrestling, get the takedown, waste no time. Try to go around the gut. Good job there by Biemkowski. But he is in a hole down 4. Not a lot right now from the Polish corner. It's probably one of those situations where you just want to get your athlete into the corner, regroup a little bit.
Regroup him, tell him he's got to be offensive. He's going to need to create some angles. As Osmanov right now is controlling the tempo, controlling the pace, and controlling the scoreboard.
I always felt wrestling coaches, especially on the international side, and really this carries over to folk style, you have a limited amount of time. You better be an exceptional communicator to get your message across.
Absolutely, and sometimes, you know, depending on the athlete, every athlete needs something a little bit different. There's only but so much you can say besides maybe smacking them upside the head and saying, get to work.
See the different approaches. Poland very calm in the corner, relaxed. Well, when you have a guy who's wrestled in several world championships, you've pushed every button, so you're not going to tell this guy anything new.
Exactly. And like, you know, once you get to the world championships, you hopefully have the haze in the barn, as it's said, and you just try and get them as pumped up and as mentally prepared as they can be.
You have to see the offense that Biemkowski is capable of. He's very good in the upper body tie-ups. Poland strong and Greco-Roman. Here's a low shot coming in between the legs into a waterfall position. Draped over the top goes the Polish wrestler. What's Osmanov want to do here to try to finish and get the two?
He wants to isolate one of the legs, so he wants to reach to the inside like he's doing right now. He wants to pull that down and try to swing the body. Biankowski did a great job of holding on tight, squeezing his thighs around the ears of Osmanov. But that shot was textbook. He got a good inside reach, pulled Biankowski forward. Biankowski popped up. He was able to get an attack. That was well done defensively by Biankowski.
Biankowski with his first shot coming in on that outside single, and he will get the point. That time Biankowski got to his offense, and he nets the one.
Kyrgyzstan, Uzbekistan, Tajikistan, one of the things that they do really well, and it's the old Soviet system, is they're never squeezing too tight. So they're really kind of flowing with their hands, but then when they want to go and they snap on the head, you see stars. So it's that push and pull, that loose and tight, never really knowing where they are. And they're magically able to just move out of the way sometimes. It's a beautiful thing to watch.
...4-1 remains the score. Kyrgyzstan on top, 40 seconds to go in this final period. Biankowski searching for his first world medal.
And Osmanov able to keep him at bay with that hand, but just keep enough distance so Biankowski is going to have to shoot straight in, and that's not going to work. And I know that he's feeling that he needs to have it right now, but there's not a setup there, and you're not going to get past, you know, in a bronze medal match, past their head and hands defense without setting up and clearing those arms.
Big head tap that time by Poland to no avail. And Kyrgyzstan is going to earn a bronze medal. 24-year-old Alibek Osmanov. Very businesslike approach. Acts like he's been here before. A bronze medal at 65. Enjoying the best 36-hour stretch of his senior-level career and putting it all together.
Bringing home that bronze medal to Kyrgyzstan. That's big for the country and big for Alibek Osmanov.
Now you were mentioning tendencies. That's a good point. When you look at the geographical tendencies of the world, do you see that?